Yeah.
Hello, everyone. I'm Renato De Castro, Global Ambassador for TM Forum Smart City Agenda. And today I'm in Madrid. And as I said in my last video, I'll be traveling around the world and well, trying to bring to you what is new in smart cities. And I'm in a very interesting event here in Madrid called ICAM. And I just heard about a very nice reframe of our old concept that really fits to a smart city. And well, it's quite disruptive, even for me, that I'm everywhere listening what people are talking about smart cities. So I'm here today with Rob Monster. Rob is the president of Digital Town, one of the companies that are speaking here in this event. And Rob is one of the global, well, one of the few people in the globe talking about this, what he calls smart web. So thank you very much to be with us in TM Forum. We have just launched a very disruptive benchmarking tools to compare smart cities, and we are very worried about how we can measure and leverage, or at least balance, smart cities around the world. And what I heard before from you is that, well, world of registers and well, internet is also thinking about smart city, right?
Yes.
So tell us, first of all, what kind of event is this, and yeah, what's smart web?
You bet. So Renato, delighted to visit with you and to share what's going on with the domain industry and this emerging thing called the smart web. ICANN is the global regulator of the domain industry. It meets quarterly with the stakeholders all around the world. And this particular event called the GDD Summit brings together the stakeholders that operate many of the registries, particularly the new emerging registries that are now descriptive. You may have come across names like .london,
yep.
As well as names like .shop and .art and .law and many, many more that are descriptive. And so what's happening is the web is becoming intuitive. It's becoming more obvious where would I go to find whatever I'm looking for, and also what will I expect when I get there. So this is a very big part of how to make the web more useful, how to make it more relevant for the coming decades. And it just so happens to be converging at a time when cities are trying to become smart. And so the exciting opportunity that we have in the domain industry is to come together with the smart city architects and envision this notion of what we call a smart web. A smart web being a web that is intuitive, it's personalized and secure, made possible through an intuitive network of descriptive domain extensions that are also able to make use of a single sign-on framework for portable identity and portable reputation. So the net result is a web that's intuitive, personalized, and secure.
You're telling me that web was seen till now much more as a tool, and with this new concept, web is becoming now a driver to smart city, right? I mean, it's really something that it's active. It's not just one more tool that we can use for smart cities, right?
Absolutely. I think that the big concept that is unfolding for smart city innovators, both on the commercial side and on the public side, is this notion of an interoperable framework of smart cities connected through a smart web, made possible through a smart wallet, that is now solving one of the critical issues, which is how are we going to get the consumer to engage with all of this smart city innovation that we're investing in at the municipal level, right? So the municipal approach has been a siloed approach that is city by city. Now, what happens for the visitor from out of city or out of country who is now coming to your city for the first time, trying to take full benefit of all of these wonderful innovations, and they're completely confused and bewildered? The web should become interoperable, but cities should become interoperable as well.
We have already, well, very non-global solutions for this, but what you're saying is that we need to go local, right? I mean, if I want to go to a place and stay in a hotel or in someone's house, sharing economy is really popping up now, but why not searching inside the city and not in a global platform, right?
Yeah, no, it's a great question. And there are certain use cases that we all have, retail services, dining, lodging, that are highly local. And so for that, there is this notion of a dot city, like dot London, dot Berlin, dot Amsterdam, dot Miami, but also the dot city extension. So the cities that don't have their own unique extension that is branded in the identity of the city they can use the .city. So Nashville.city, San Diego.city, and so forth and so on. So when you're searching local, you're interested in things that are immediately available within the general proximity of the city that you're visiting or where you reside. However, when it comes to actions like, for example, shopping or art or legal services, you're not necessarily limited to a specific city as to what it is that you're necessarily searching for. You're willing to contemplate maybe national providers or even international providers. And if you're a retailer and you're using, for example, a .co.uk or a .com or a .de, you're implicitly saying to the world, I don't want to sell to you because I'm a German and you don't want to buy from me because I have a .de. Now, many retailers are responding to this by going and getting all the different extensions from all the different parts of the world, but that in turn creates added complexity, added cost, and it reduces your search engine rank because you're not getting as much visitors going to one particular site and staying there. The content management systems of today, the online commerce solutions of today, are fully capable of being multi-language, multi-currency. So using a .shop for retail, using a .law for legal services, using a .art for selling art. It's a very, very significant shift, but it's happening at the perfect time, and the smart city innovators are in a position to bring this change.
And it's really rude, right? I was listening to you and I was thinking, and well, you're telling me that we already have something going on, and the smart that London, right, will be launched now during the London Tech Week. So this is a real case
yes.
of what can be done worldwide, right?
Yes.
So what is smart that London?
Yes.
And yeah, people that coming to join us, I will be one of the speakers there during the several events during the London Tech Week. Well, what they can find already there next month in London?
Yeah, it's a super exciting initiative. Smart.London is both an event with the London Tech Week to introduce the UK tech community to this notion of a smart city powered on the web. But fundamentally, what will happen at Smart.London is it becomes the homepage for Londoners, whether you're a visitor or whether you're a resident. It becomes your homepage for being able to know where to go, what to do, where to stay, how to pay, who to meet, and search local. See the world through local eyes, whether you're a resident or a visitor. Now, what's also going on during London Tech Week is we'll be doing a hackathon. Our chief technical officer, Mike Cartwright, who is a native of Newcastle, longtime Londoner, will be hosting the hackathon where we will provide the developer toolkit to developers, not just in London, but frankly anywhere in the world, who wish to add their innovative concepts and make them available.
Co-creation, right?
It's co-creation.
Yeah,
it's co-creation.
Really concept,
it's co-creation, but in a way that is not winner-take-all, like you have, say, for example, in the case of Uber and Airbnb, where you have monoliths that are emerging. No, what we're talking about here is concepts like homeshare.london and bikeshare.london and storage.london and all of these types of concepts that are built around this notion of a sharing economy. But instead of having individual entrepreneurs and developers creating applications that have to build trust, by adding the overlay of a smart wallet, there's the ability to separate the application from identity and payment. In other words, you don't have to trust implicitly the architect of that particular piece of software with all of your personal information. That information is residing in the cloud once. It's single sign-on across all of the applications that are part of this smart web. And the net result is a frictionless engagement, but also the ability to avoid the added effort of having to create new profiles every time and the added concern of who exactly has my PII, my personal information that you choose to safeguard by managing it centrally in the cloud with your own definition of who has permission to see it.
That's fantastic. In just 5 minutes, we got to address sharing economy, creative economy, circular economy, co-creation, and open data and open platform. That's really, for me, really sounds like smart city. I've been discussing with my audience already a long time. Smart city is it's a change in mindset. We must build it together, but there is no owner, right? It belongs to everyone. And I love the idea to be a citizen online. So if I want to have Renato de Castro that London, I can have it, right?
You can have it.
Great. Okay, so, well, It's already the invitation. See you now in London next month, in London Tech Week. I'll be there speaking. And, well, join us there as well. Thank you very much, Rob. Thank you very much for your audience. See you in next video.